Il cibo?
Il cibo ogni tanto dà problemi. Il cibo, soprattutto a pranzo e a cena, ogni tanto fa delle brutte sorprese. Però
siamo qua. Che abbiamo...
Siamo qua, dobbiamo andare avanti.
Telefono.
Telefono, Uber,
pizza.
McDonald's.
The food, they're used to eating the rice that they normally eat. Their change of diet is going to change very quickly, so they've got to get used to that as well.
Makanan di sini enak bergizi. Kalau makanan Indo asal-asal makan itu tidak ada yang sehat itu. Kalau di sini nggak ada rasa mas, cuma apa ya kayak asam gitu. Kalau di Indo kan ada manis, pedas gitu, enak.
Yeah, so one of the things we found when we went over to Indonesia was culturally, a lot of their stuff's kind of deep fried, so the boys kind of love that, and that's kind of one of the things that we're going to try and cut out and educate them while they're over here on what they should be eating and what's going to help them become the best athlete that they can be, really.
Mi manca un bel piatto di pasta. Fa tanto un piatto di pasta. Qua non la mangiamo tanto. Mangiamo sempre riso e pollo. Vabbè, salutare per il nostro corpo, ma un bel piattone di pasta ogni tanto fa bene.
So I work really closely with the hotel's head chef, Andy. So recently I've had some discussions with him about adapting breakfast, just because I think the boys need a little bit more protein and energy for the pre-season that they're doing, because they're working really hard at the moment. So it's again just trying to adapt everything we do from a nutrition standpoint to match up with the training.
So the last few days we've just been continuing on with 1,000 metre running, hard running, building the boys up, a little bit more distance every day.
We tested all of them on a 5K run to see who's capable, and unfortunately a couple of them had to stop and walk. So because they stopped and walked, we realised that we need some endurance in some of these boys.
Boys have been working really, really hard, to be fair. Not ideal conditions either, it's really rainy and cold, but they're putting it in, which is great to see. 2, 1, go.
Tadi saya habis latihan sprint 6 km dan sangat berat sekali rasanya latihan sprint di musim salju.
Getting used to doing that sort of running and recovering quickly and going again, we're seeing some good improvements and some good work rate from the boys. Bagus sekali. Well done.
Sangat membantu untuk menjaga kekebalan tubuh, memperkuat tenaga. Biar enggak mudah capek kalau pertandingan.
3, 4, 5. Otherwise you do another one. Both of you.
Both. Berdua harus 3, 4, 5 waktu lo sekarang.
Ayo bang, ayo bang. Ayo bisa, 3, 4, 5.
Ibtoh bisa, ayo.
Ibtoh, come on. Put your arm around him.
Ayo, Ibtoh bisa, ayo.
These guys are footballers and that's what they enjoy, that's what they love. So of course, if you're just running every day, it can be hard, it can be tiring, and it can wear you down a little bit. So today will probably be one of the first times we've been able to get the balls out and train in small groups again, so I'm sure the boys will be looking forward to that.
You know, we're here to help them develop going forward, and that's our aim. And that's nothing better would please me. And as they go on to develop and they play at a high level, nothing would please me more.
Yeah, they've created their own opportunity. We haven't created it, they've created it themselves. The first thing that we find that really gives them a chance and opportunity is to bring their fitness and their strength up to speed. We try and give them the vehicle and their ability will do the rest.
I think it was a good session. The lads were very lively. Just great to get back out on the footballs. Obviously, having a bit of a period of time where they've not been able to get the balls out and they've done a lot of running, a lot of fitness work. Although it's great that they're having a bit of a pre-season and getting themselves fit, most important thing is to get them on the balls when we can, and I thought the session was good today. As a coach, you want to see individuals improve. So for me, if you can pick out two or three players early on that you think he's got potential, but he needs to work on these areas of his game, and if you can put a program together that helps him improve them areas, and at the end of the 5 months, you can see that he's improved to a level that you've helped with and you've had a part in that, then I think, you know, that's always pleasing.
Save, Andre, save!
Hopefully the benefits will come later on when we start playing games again. You'll see how fit we are as a team, and you'll hopefully see the rewards in terms of the performance.
I think I have conversations individually with the boys, and depending on what their goals may be. So we do a lot of height, weight and body fat testing. So everyone might have a different goal.
Make sure the calorie intake's where it needs to be for them to train hard every day and recover properly from hard training sessions and hard gym sessions. That also includes working closely with the players to find out what they're enjoying eating. So find out what they want and try and include that into the meals as well to keep them happy.
And cibo?
Yeah. Il cibo ogni tanto dà problemi.
Ogni tanto, se adesso ci portano sempre un attimo
le uova e fagioli. Le uova sono anche buone. Il problema sono un po' i fagioli, però si lasciano lì. E il cibo, soprattutto a pranzo e cena, ogni tanto fa delle brutte sorprese. Però
meno male che ci abbiamo.
Siamo qua, dobbiamo andare avanti.
Telefono,
Uber,
pizza.
The lockdown's helped us kind of control the meals really well, but then on days off the boys do like to go to Tesco's and get lots of snacks, which is understandable. You know, they're working really hard so they can enjoy their food as well. I want them to enjoy their food. Again, like I said, it's just a case of educating them.
Makan dong, Mas. Cemilan, Mas. Cemilan jepul kembali. Yeah.
Perfectnya.
Yang ini beda, Mas.
Yeah.
Tapi sama, Mas. KW Squad.
Yang ini, Mas. Aku yang ini beda, Mas. Gak ada di kampung aku.
Gak boleh. Makan coklat. Gak boleh.
Gak boleh makan coklat, Mas.
Kalau Jake lihat, menurut kamu dia bakal bilang apa?
Gak tahu. Coklat. Coklat.
Apa yang terjadi? Apa sih yang kalian lagi tonton?
Ini masih kemenangan Bagus
Kahfi.
Frezi.
Mati Brocio! Gol! Gol di cerita yang sangat menarik. Luar biasa sekali. Bagaimana seorang Frezi melakukan determinasi dan juga lihat tidak ada konsentrasi dari para pemain.
Ya udah dua-duanya aja, Mas.
Klik-klik. Ya, dan pasti.
Jamet.
Dit. Ya pasti.
Iya.
Sebelum Garuda Select, ada beberapa teman saya di sini yang menjadi rival saya. Di Indonesia saya bermain di klub Persibaya dan di sini ada banyak teman saya dari Persibaya yang kepilih Garuda Select. Ada Randy, Adit.
Ya. Ya.
Dan klub saya Persibaya masuk semifinal dan ketemu tim Bayangkara FC. Dan di tim Bayangkara FC ada Freddy sama Faki.
Sama Ridwan.
Pernah bertemu Adit, Wahyu dan Randy di final semifinal Elite Pro U16. Dia di klub Persibaya Surabaya.
Bagus Freddy.
Tensi lumayan cukup tinggi, ya ada benturan keras dan itu membuat jadi agak nggak enak aja di sini karena dulu pas semifinal. Benturannya pas saya kan satu lawan satu, saya sudah terlewat dari Wahyu dan saya tackle dia dan lumayan keras benturan tackle itu. Gak pernah, karena kan itu dia juga kan kalau di dalam pertandingan itu lawan dan kalau di luar lapangan itu teman, jadi jangan nggak pernah ngungkit masalah di lapangan. Bayangkara FC dengan skor 1-0, Adit kegolan di menit terakhir di menit 60+2, umpan dari Freji kan Cornel. Passing, Freji bawa di crossing. Vera itu Mas, tinggal golin pakai
Freji.
They've come together as a group, you know, off the pitch. You can have certain times where you're feeling a little bit low and you're down. And I think as a group and as a group of friends and a sort of a family feel, they've definitely got each other up and got each other through it. And you know, they're all in it together.
Sangat membantu Mas, karena sering berbincang-bincang bareng juga Mas. Karena kan lockdown ini nggak bisa kemana-mana, ya paling menyempatkan waktu untuk kadang-kadang bermain game bersama Reggie dan Faris.
There's going to be times where in games, you know, you need to dig in and you need to feel that togetherness. And I think during the lockdown period, they've definitely built that.
1, 2, 3, Garuda Select, jaya!
Tadi kita habis halo. Zoom bareng Bagus dan kawan-kawan yang ada di sini.
Halo.
Halo, 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 halo.
Halo, halo, halo.
Halo, 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 Cak. Si. Tak dengar kamar sih.
Bisa terkenal sih di Indonesia. Dia terkenal karena kemampuannya saat membela tim nasional Indonesia di ajang Piala AFF dan kualifikasi Piala Asia.
Bagus is and brilliant, a great examples. They came here for 2 seasons, and Bagus is now signed for a European club, Utrecht.
One of the best club in Holland, one of the biggest club in this country. So I hear a lot about this club.
I'm Jordi Zuidam. I'm the technical director of FC Utrecht. We got a tip from our network, and they told us about Bagus, his football qualities and his ambitions to play football in Europe. Yeah, I also spoke with Dennis Weiss about him. Yeah, he told us about his scoring qualities and also about the talent of the boy. And he had a very bad injury, but he recovered almost from it. then we have the trial, and we saw the qualities by ourselves, and we are convinced about his potential.
Sebenarnya target saya sama sih kayak Mas Bagus, ingin membuka kesempatan bermain di klub Eropa dan menjadi pemain profesional.
Bagus! Run him again and again and again!
It was lovely for them to speak with them, chat with them, for the guys to give them their experience of the last two seasons and what they've been through.
Mas Bagus, mau nanya, saran apa yang bisa Mas Bagus kasih ke kita supaya kita maksimal di Garuda Select?
Biar maksimal di sana ya, selalu ingat pada tujuan awal sih. Jadi jangan sia-siakan kesempatan yang ada di sana. Membuktikan aja. Jadi yang penting berikan yang terbaik, kerja keras, kan itu juga yang disenangin sama Coach Jess dan Coach Dennis, semua staf pelatih. Kalau misal kita bekerja keras, kita semangat dalam latihan maupun bertanding, pasti selalu ada hasilnya.
Yang kedua, sebesar apa sih rasa bersyukur Mas Bagus terhadap kehadiran Dennis dan Des sampai bisa berada di posisi sekarang?
Oh ya, sangat-sangat bersyukur lah bisa berangkat ke Inggris. Gak pernah bayangkan bisa berangkat ke Inggris dan bertemu sama mantan pemain-pemain hebat dan sekarang melatih jadi mantan pemain hebat dan pelatih hebat juga. Sangat-sangat bersyukur lah dikelilingi sama orang-orang baik, orang-orang hebat dan
Sebelumnya sih saya belum pernah ketemu sama dia, cuma pernah gitu kayak DM-DM-an di Instagram. Waktu saya mau tanding, saya minta semangat ke dia, minta motivasi biar saya lebih semangat lagi untuk bertanding.
Mas Bagus, Mas.
Minta ballback, caraka.
Bisa minta sesuatu gak, Mas?
Caraka.
Boleh.
Fallback Instagram, Mas.
Apa namanya, nanti ku fallback.
Aku hoki caraka, Mas. Andus.
Saya mau Mas Faiz, Mas.
Aman, abisin tak fallback kalian ya.
Ya ini Mas, Mas Brilian juga, Mas.
Mas Brilian juga, Mas.
Ada yang tanya pacarnya bagus gak? Ya, tadi kita ngerasain ya, ternyata dia humoris dan ramah, asik. Saran tadi cuman kita harus kerja keras dan kita ikuti kata pelatih. Itu aja sih setahu saya.
Pesan penutupnya ya, jangan sia-siakan kesempatan lah, udah jauh-jauh kayak gini, terus menghabiskan waktu jauh dari keluarga, jauh dari kampung halaman, saatnya membuktikan buat bangga dua orang tua dan pastinya bangsa dan negara aja sih. Semangat.
Of course it takes also a lot of guts to succeed and to make the choice to play football here far away from his family and to invest in himself. Yeah, he is a very nice person but very eager to be successful in Utrecht.
We kind of hope that now people will look at him up there and see that he's had an opportunity, he's developed and he's gone on to good things, hopefully.
They really good to with the young players. They give me a lot of advice. So yeah, they help me so much to get this.
Hopefully, we can help with Bagus to make it a successful story, and that he will be important for FC Utrecht and also important for his country.
Untuk kalau yang di kontrak Utrecht ya, nggak ada yang saya pun juga nggak nyangka saya bisa mungkin bergabung di tim hebat, tim besar di salah satu negara Belanda, dan itu adalah suatu kebanggaan buat saya. Cuman kan tidak cukup di situ aja, saya harus bisa bekerja keras di sana, saya harus bisa membuktikan ke diri saya sendiri kalau saya di sana bisa survive di luar negeri juga. Itu sih.
Oke, makasih Mas, saran dan motivasinya. Semoga sukses di FC Utrecht.
Amin Rayu, sukses di sana, semangat.
Amin, siap.
Semangat semuanya.
Makasih Mas Bagus.
At the end of the day, this is a boy that came to us a couple of years ago. This is a boy that developed and got better under us.
like Indonesia is so big country, and I think there is so much talent. Of course, it has to start with one player, but I think if it will be a successful story, then there will come more and more players. That is the most important, that people believe in themselves and believe in their individual potential, get chances, and then make the right steps.
Can you wait for the moment you maybe ever gonna be a player in the first team here?
Yeah, we don't know about that. But I have a target. I have a plan. I have a goal. Of course, once to play in the first team. So we don't know about that.
Wish you the best. Good luck.
Thank you very much. Danke well.
Danke well.
Come on, you're all right.
The whole training regime for the last 2-3 weeks is of a real sort of premiership standard.
And you can see improvement already in terms of their general fitness.
Seruk ringan.
Katanya kamu kan dulu punya prinsip, kalau orang mau maju katanya harus sakit hati dulu, jatuh bangun, makanya kesempatan ini jangan disia-siakan.